Live event brought to you by Chevy. It's the men's 4x400 meter relay. And the U.S. holds the world and Olympic record in this event. And Sean Merritt found a novel way to hold the baton. Doesn't look too secure. And again, the U.S. men and women wearing the red singlets in honor of the host country, China. Only they would wear blue. The Rooney team is in here, and yesterday in the opening round, their anchor, Martin Rooney, made what I thought was a cardinal mistake. First of all, taunting your opponent, poor sportsmanship, but also giving the Jamaicans extra incentive as if they needed it.
Yeah, that was not the smartest move in the world. He told the BBC that he has just never been in the lead before. We'll see if he gets a chance to be in the lead here tonight.
There he is. He'll run the anchor leg for the British. In lane two will be Australia with their leadoff runner, Sean Rowe. They were silver medalists in Athens. They don't have a good lane, but they do have a quality quartet. John Stephenson on third, one of the best quarter miles in the world. Great stick action there. You see him playing with the stick. Hope he's that well when it's time to hand it off.
They just have to keep it close for him.
In lane four, the Russian Federation has set a national record in their heat yesterday, their leadoff man, Dale Dean.
And Russia's had a really great Olympic Games in terms of the relays. Three of the four teams between the men and the women have made the relay finals.
Lane five, the Bahamas, silver medalists at the World Championships, ran without Chris Brown in their qualifying round. Their leadoff man, Andretti Bain, was a pair of big fans of Mario Andretti.
What a great name for a guy who needs to run fast. This is the NCAA champion. The time he ran to win that NCAA title would have been second here at the Olympic Games of 400 meters. They are anchored by that fourth place finisher.
Andretti Bain won the NCAA championship for Oral Roberts. Here at the British team, they won their heat yesterday. And their leadoff man, Andrew Steele.
And of course, we'll be looking at the anchor, Martin Rooney, with the showboating yesterday.
Sean Merritt runs the leadoff leg for the U.S.
Arguably the best 400 meter runner in the world. And listen to this lineup: with Sean Merritt, gold in the 400. Angelo Taylor, gold in the 400 hurdles. David Neville, the guy for bronze in the 400. And then Jeremy Warner, 400 silver.
Belgium set a national record at its heat yesterday. Cedric Van Brettenham will be on that team. This is Kevin Borley, who's the leadoff man.
They set the national record in the heat, and they've got an anchor that's really strong. He's got 44 seconds speed. They got to keep it close.
Outside lane, lane 9 is Jamaica with Michael Blackwood leading off. Jamaica's only win in this event back in 1952.
But this event is a source of huge pride, given the exploits of men like Herb McKinley in Jamaica's past. And I can tell you, out of lane 9, I would keep my eye on Jamaica. They are dangerous from out there. You have to get to 11th on the all-time list before you even find another country in the 4x4 all-time list. And there has never been this quality of leadoff leg, maybe ever. The closest probably Danny Everett in Seoul, the bronze medalist, who led off in 43.79. The reason that leadoff split has remained for so long as the fastest is because usually that quality athlete does not lead off. And here we have the Olympic champion, Sean Merritt, leading off. The United States.
U.S. has won 17 out of 22 gold medals. And on their way, the 4x400 meter relay.
And the Sean Merritt, the guy that has great confidence in his 400 meter speed, and with that gold already in his pocket, he can now relax, run hard, and have fun and try to set the U.S. up for a magical performance here. That day's rest for the Sean Merritt in between his 400 and now in his final is going to serve him well in this last 100 meters.
So the Sean Merritt of the United States as they come off the turn hit the home straightaway. Merritt, Jamaica, Belgium, Great Britain. Here's the first baton exchange. inside, and here they come with Angela Taylor in front for the United States.
34 flat lead off of the Shawn Merritt, but now here comes everybody else trying to keep pace with Angela Taylor. Such experience for Taylor at running these 4x4s at this level.
Taylor has the U.S. in front, Belgium is second, Bahamas third, Russia fourth, Jamaica fifth. Great Britain, Poland. And the handoff, the baton now in the hands of David Neville.
And this is a little bit of a surprise. Look at Belgium in second. They were not supposed to be at this stage at this point, but David Neville with a lot of daylight between him and second and third place.
Belgium is second, Bahamas third, Jamaica fourth, Great Britain fifth.
43.9 for Angelo Taylor on that second leg. And look at how wide he's blown this race open for David Neville.
Who's had a memorable Olympics. Dive for bronze in the 400 and now leading his leg. Belgium second, Bahamas third, Jamaica fourth, Russia fifth, Great Britain sixth. And Jeremy Warner runs the anchor for the United States.
And Jeremy Warner has anchored every U.S. team since Michael Johnson retired. 44-1 for Neville on third. And right how you see him there, how he looks anytime he's anchoring, the picture of relaxation for Jeremy Warner down the backstretch. Bahamas clearly in second now.
U.S. with a huge lead. Bahamas in second. Russia takes over third. Belgium back to fourth. Great Britain fifth. Jamaica sixth. Here's the home straightaway. Jeremy Warner of the United States. Warner galloping through the stretch. Bahamas is second and Russia's gaining on them. But it will be the U.S. and Jeremy Warner winning the gold medal again. Bahamas holding on by a stride over Russia for the silver.
And this team ran over their heads an Olympic record for the U.S. quartet. On paper, it did not seem like they would be able to do it. But they ran over their heads given how some of these young men ran in that 400 meter final. Olympic record 255.39 for the United States. A fantastic performance for the U.S.
So another U.S. victory in the 4x4 as their domination of this relay in the Olympics continues with that star-studded cast. Shawn Merritt, who did get the U.S. off to that good start, the strategy for putting him first paid off for the U.S.
And not only did it pay off, it turned this race into really a walk because this was supposed to be a little bit closer on paper. But as we look at the exchanges, this is what Shawn Merritt, after that brilliant 44 flat, comes in, hands off to Angelo Taylor, who has the second fastest split of the night on second, 43.9 for Angelo Taylor. And when he was done, this race was all but over. He hands to David Neville, who already has bronze in the 400. He takes a step into the outside lane and corrects 44-1 for him. And then when Warner got this stick, I figured 256 at best and another normal win for the United States. But Warner 43-2, a masterful anchor leg. The Olympic record belongs to the U.S. once again.
Warner with an anchor leg made sure as the U.S. breaks an Olympic record that it stood since 1992.